Hey guys, what's going on? Welcome to another video. As you can see, we're playing Path of Exile. So I've been playing this game for a little while. Played last league, this league. Played a little bit in the one before as well, but just kind of dabbled. This one, I've kind of been a little bit more confident in what I'm doing with it. As you can see, done a couple of different characters. Just messing around. It's mostly been in the last couple of days more than anything. Last week or so. But above all, I played a lot of hardcore Diablo. And I've wanted to get into hardcore PoE, so I figured, you know what, I'm going to take it nice and slow, play a new character, new build, play it along, record the episodes, and see how far we get. And just to point out, this isn't meant to be some, like, professional series. You're not going to, like, be learning all of the latest tactics and things like that. It's just not going to happen. It's meant for new players or people that just want to just chill out, hang out. I might even stream some of these one day. But yeah, so I'm going to be going towards playing a tornado shot barrage. I can't decide if I'm going to go Raider or Pathfinder. Pathfinder's the better one ultimately. But requires like a lot more gear for it to be at that level. Whereas Raider's just a little bit safer, so probably Raider in fairness just to start off with. But let's beat up Hillock. Let's not fail the first mission, shall we? So yeah, like I said, I've been playing a little while. Typically playing like SRS has been my build just for a long time. I'm actually picking up everything just because I don't think I've played any hardcore yet, so my vault is likely empty, so you can always get rid of it for the scroll fragment parts. Right, let's ID the shoes. Move speed, not move speed. Farewell. Have I got anything? Oh, okay. Randomly got a shield. I've got a couple of things, but nothing major. Let's get rid of everything. See if we can get a... yeah, let's go for split arrow to start off with. Is there any move speed boots? Like I said, we're not going to be running through this at like Mach 10. However, if we can pick up some stuff to make it a little bit quicker, we shall. But yeah, I've really been enjoying playing it. I've actually been recommended to play a bow class as like my first main hardcore character. I was actually playing SRS. I tried SRS Summoner as my first one this last league. It went well. Got to like 50 something. And made a silly mistake that got me killed. The biggest points that I find in hardcore are just after like the resistance drops, because you get used to like how much damage you're going to be taking and things like that, and then all of a sudden it's like real, it steps up really quickly. As you can see, I'm actually clearing a lot more than I probably need to. There's no real reason for that other than just being safe. Oh, this is fun. Normally I would just skip these, but like on softcore, so softcore you would probably just run straight to Tile Island, go through, kill the boss, whatever. Like I said, we want to do this as safe as possible, so being overleveled isn't the worst thing in the world. Ta-da! Right, can do that now, can sustain myself on mana. And let's go. So yeah, my whole plan is to get like a Doomfletch tornado shot set up with a barrage like link in, or barrage set up in my chest. Hopefully that should give me boss damage, clear speed, things like that as well. I think it's probably one of the most like versatile builds for being able to clear things from what I've seen at the moment anyway. I have no doubt like people can go summoners and probably be a lot safer. Spectra summoners are probably a lot safer. But I find these fun, and like I said, it can do everything, so why not? So we've had double iron rings. It's another flask, which means we can upgrade them to medium. So like I said, if you've played the game, you know what you're talking about. I do apologize. There's going to be a lot of like noob tips. Three flasks of the same level you can turn into the tier above. So three small flasks, I can turn that into a medium one when I go back to town in a second. That's actually mud flasks. Why did I go in that? I am actually going to go back and do Tidal Island. It's really inefficient. But whatever. Like I said, we're not here to get crazy amounts of efficiency. Just because it's... You've got to work your way into hardcore. Hopefully I'm not just going to randomly die at some point. Because that would be pretty embarrassing. But yeah, this is a really simple sort of concept build. In that there's nothing... There's no weird mechanics you've got to learn around. There's a cast when damage taken setup. There's a curse on the hit setup. And then it's basically Blink Arrow and your two damage abilities. So it really is simple. There's nothing particularly difficult about the build. Which makes it pretty cool for new starters as well. But yeah, so trying to find... Frosty dude. I'm actually surprised by how quick this is clearing, considering what it is. And there's Hellrake. Hopefully I can just face tank him now, because I really can't bother just clicking away. So we actually got a medium life flask. Sorry, that word was not coming out there. And I leveled again. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm just not going to go back yet. There's just no reason for me to. It's a big bank over there. Let's just kill him off quickly. And you can see already like why this is strong for... Hardcore, you're such a safe distance away, and the damage it does is just crazy. Like, nothing outside of bosses has got to me yet. So, big thing for anyone playing for this, like, for the first time, you have to really concentrate for bosses. Bosses are, like, one of the hardest things leveling your first character up. I'm always fine for the first act. Actually, it's the slammy dude from the second act that I have a lot of issues with. We'll see when we get to him. But yeah, I have a lot of issues with him. It just doesn't work with me for some reason. Obviously, it is hardcore. Going to be going quite defensive in my tree. There's no need to go full out offensive, especially with like a ranger bow, because realistically, you're going to do enough damage anyway. So, a little tippet, you can actually unequip your chest, you'll get more move speed, however, it's hardcore, rather have the extra defensive stats. But there you go, so like, I've got nothing special on, no twink gear or anything like that, and I'm still one-shotting mobs at my level. And you can't die if you can one-shot the mobs. So like I said, this isn't the most efficient run. Like I said, you get twink gear, you could do whatever, but we're going to go through, we're going to get the first portal, and we're going to go back to town, hand in the quests, and realistically, that's what, 10 minutes? It's not bad, it's not the best, but like I said, we can take it nice and chill for it being hardcore. Let me know what you think about me doing like PoE videos. I hope you guys like them. I love the game. If I could get into it a little bit more, that would be really cool. I don't know what I spoke to him, that's a waste of time. I can't remember what I won. can't actually remember what I want. We're just going to stick that in right now. Got a job for you. Sorry, guys. I've literally just logged on. I'm being a potato. Mm-hmm. So what I'm going to do is get rid of these. Don't want to get rid of that, but upgraded my... So there we go. So now we've got two medium life flasks, a quicksilver, and we're pretty set to go back out. So if you see portal scrolls early on, make sure you're picking them up. Portal scrolls are really important. You can also set up the like logout macros for hardcore. Obviously softcore isn't too important, but hardcore you could set logout macros. I'm not going to do them personally. Just because no real need. If I die, I die. I'm not going to get too upset about it. Like I said, it's pretty late into the season anyway, so it's not like I'm going to be like pushing to be the very best. So this is actually a Harbinger and boss, and I'm just kiting back, hitting everything, and not having any issue at all. There we go. That wasn't particularly difficult considering what it was. And like I said, no twin gear, whatever. The idea of this build is you end up going for like a fair bit of evasion. If you go for the Pathfinder one, you do a stupid ton of damage. You build up on resistances through flasks, which is pretty cool. But probably not going to follow that one just because, like I said, it's a lot of gear needed. And I'm trying to do this without needing to buy loads. I'll probably buy stuff, but obviously I have no currency. So it's all about what I can sustain or what I can actually afford as well. Is this another Harbinger? Wow. So yeah, a lot of people are really scared to do things like a hardcore just because they don't want their time to be wasted. And I'm not going to say I'm the best player by any means. I'm already over leveled. So this zone is level 5. I'm level 6 already. I'm doing that purely for the fact that why not? Like, if I can be over leveled, it helps me. So yeah, I'm kind of killing everything. It's a bit unnecessary. I've got two skill points, actually, that I need to work through in a second. Both, again, look, we're going to go pure defense. There's actually a short bow there, which I could have picked up. I'm actually tempted to go back and get it. So I'm going to start skipping some mobs now because I am quite over-leveled. Actually, I need to go and find Crab Daddy. So this is a nice trick, is that because if you can use something like that choke point, you can funnel mobs in and you're just going to do a ton. Here, let's actually do this. We're going to go back up. We're going to go through into ledge, clear ledge till the portal, and then come back to Crab Daddy. Boom. So, nothing difficult too far. Like, so far. Again, over-leveled. If you're not confident in hardcore, over-level. Like, it's really simple. It's not the most efficient. However, if you're doing, like, your first couple of hardcore characters, they're just not going to be efficient to start off with. The good thing with this is that it will be efficient anyway in maps. I can't help but be efficient. Really want Blink Arrow. Would help this significantly. So I'm going to try and actually skip a load of mobs here unless I see a real big pack. I've randomly been killed by these, so I'm always super, like, skeptical about them. Like, just running past them. But they're a decent amount of XP. They're not great, but... Like I said, I'm not even kiting right now, and I'm just standing here face tanking, and they're all dying pretty quickly. There we go. So again, like, there's no skill involved in what I've just done. I've just stood there and held right click and that died. So I'm going to go back, look for Crab Daddy, because we want the extra skill points early. Mainly because finesse, quite nice. Gives us a little bit of attack speed, which would help us. Of course, I'm not actually going to be able to find it. I think it's done here. There we go. So again, we've gone ahead a little bit, got over leveled, and so it's like a level 6 zone. I'm level 7. We can just go in here. I'm going to walk past everything. I'm just going to skip everything now. I'm going to start getting a little bit more confident because we've seen that I've got the damage to pretty much clear things just very, very quickly. So what I'm actually going to do after this is log out and hand in the quest, teleport back to ledge, and then we can carry on leveling. Like I said, none of this is particularly hard, and I'm learning as much as I'm probably going to try and help you guys, but yeah, we'll see what we can pick up in the whole process. Another harboring. So I'm trying to keep up the dot from Caustic Arrow as well, just to keep that chaos damage ticking through. I'm actually pretty sure Caustic Arrow is probably better single target still. Yeah, it definitely is. Alright, anything I need? Nope. So we log out, we go back to town, we can hand that in then for the reward. Check for move speed boots, because like I said, move speed boots also help us kite, so having them is definitely a good thing. I'm actually going to have a look for bows as well. Short bow, double green socket. I'm actually going to pick that up because it is better than mine significantly. Eek, come on. Stay sharp out there. We do get finesse, and that's a fair bit of damage we just picked up as well. So what we're going to do now, like I said, unless we see big packs, we're just going to try and skip things. I want to at least kill that finished prison before we finish this video. So big pack, that's the slicer room. There is no difficulty here at the moment. Like, I can just shred through pretty much everything. Like I said, it is only early, so it's not going to be particularly difficult. It does get harder later on. But if you keep track of, like, your resistances and things like that, you really don't have... shouldn't have much of an issue. I'd say a big thing is just focus on, like, resistances, health, things like that, and, like, evasion, energy shield, whatever you're going to be using. Just because if you get that right, everything else... like, it doesn't matter if it takes you a long time to kill things, if you're alive. Don't know if it's efficient to kill this, but I'm just going to do it anyway, I've already committed. Was definitely worth for getting the coral ring. That's actually really nice. Gives us some life, some resistances, some extra damage. That's terrible. That's better. So I actually like Iron Rings early just because it gives you that extra damage. And like I said, a big thing for me, just want as much damage as possible. I want to be hitting things really hard. If I can kill things before they get to me, in a pretty good space to keep myself alive, in my opinion. Next few levels don't really give me anything too much in terms of my skill tree. So if I start falling off, then I just need to be wary of that. It's about knowing all the different, like, scenarios, and I know that I might start getting to a point in a second where I run out of damage, or in a couple of levels when I run out a little bit of damage, but that's just something to be aware of. I love the noises these goats make. So yeah, I can see that obviously tooltip DPS, caustic arrow, does actually give me more damage to that DPS than split arrows, so probably going to be using that for single target. Again, don't need to kill these, however, you can if you've got the damage, there's no reason why not. They do typically drop a couple like rares and things like that. Portal scrolls, need them. Because we're going to need them for the boss in a couple of minutes. I've already unlocked Navali, but you have to do this once on like per league. So I actually just got a Siege Ballista. I'm going to chuck that in just because... does a decent amount of damage and actually can help on the boss. No other reason, like, I'm not going to use it for anything else. It's not like I'm using it directly, I'm literally just doing it because I can. So I could return back to town and get a bit of a reward, but not going to bother yet. Should have the damage to do things without too much of an issue, so I don't need to. Level 8, I'm level 8, so same level at the moment. Again, shouldn't have an issue, but it's about being aware of these things. And I'd say that's a big thing of what hardcore is in general, it is just about awareness. I know now that I'm the same level as these, so it's not going to be quite as face roll. I should just be aware of that and be able to react accordingly. I can put like a link to the skill tree that I'm going to be following if anyone's interested as well, in description. So if you had twink gear or anything like that for this, then you would literally one-shot everything, you would run through, you probably wouldn't kill anything unless you saw like a big pack. And if you did, you'd turn around, hit it once, turn around, leave. You certainly wouldn't be doing as much as I am here in terms of killing things. Because there's just... ooh, jewelers. There's just no need. Like I said, I'm doing it because the boss is in a minute and I want to just be as strong as I can be for that. So I'm currently at 3 portal scrolls. Hopefully should only need one to kill the boss. In fairness, I shouldn't need one. However, I'm going to use one just to be safe. And the advantage, so what I'm going to do is just go in, spawn a portal scroll. The advantage to that is I can go back to town, refill my flask, come back out. I've got 2 medium flasks, which actually is in a real good spot for me. I probably, with the chest I've got on as well, face tank, probably not going to. I am going to kill this, because why not? Enfeeble's not very nice, however everything else isn't really too much of an issue. So I've got a 3-link superior short bow. Not going to make much of a difference. However, I might be able to use it for something soon. There's another strong box in there. I'm actually going to go get that one as well. Getting quite lucky with this. Obviously, I had a load of Harbringers as well. Harbringers typically, at this level, come with a blue pack. Detonates nearby corpses. I'm gonna get away from that one. But again, like, I've taken almost 0 damage for the entirety of this. And that's a fair bit of currency that I can now go pick up for 3. So yeah, definitely worth doing if you see the strong boxes, especially if you've got no currency. They are pure profit. Like, you get a concentrated source of mobs as well. Definitely worth doing. All right, I'm gonna risk it. I believe they're gonna give me move speed. They didn't. What the hell? Come on. Rip. I actually didn't have the sockets I needed, and if they'd given me move speed, wouldn't have cared. I would have just taken out Siege Ballista. But... ah, well. So as you can see, skipping through a fair bit now. Just wanted to get to the boss. Already been a fairly long video, and through here... well, in a second anyway, should be Le Boss. Wouldn't be a bad idea to get another level. Wouldn't have been a bad idea to get another level. Would have been grinding out a little bit, because obviously I am already ahead. But not going to bother. The next level gives me projectile speed, projectile damage, dex, all of which gives me a little bit more damage. But it's would have been nice, but a little bit unnecessary. Alright then, let's go. So I don't really care about taking damage, truthfully. I'm going to reset my flasks 100%. I've already used the ball, so it doesn't matter. Except you can see now I probably didn't need to. If you look at how much damage I've actually done to him, I'm going to get some flash resets here off the mobs. But there we go. So we're just going to jump out now because we've already used the portal. We may as well. We can actually use the Quicksilver as well here. And that's him dead. Wasn't particularly hard. Gets a long bow. That's actually probably really nice because it gives me my three link green. Yep, that's super good. Swap them two out and we can probably get something else in there in a second. And we're going to carry on. So yeah, we're just going to go through, get to the pool. Been 31 minutes. So not a fast kill of Brutus at all. You can probably do this in 15 minutes. If you're good, even from fresh gear, no twink gear, but things like that. But it's hardcore. We've taken it nice and slow. So, guys, if you've enjoyed watching this, thank you for watching. Let me know in the comments, like, things like that. Yeah, nothing really more else to say. Thank you for watching and catch you later, guys. Goodbye.